So in 2011, I believe it was, while you were at St. John's, you were diagnosed with prostate cancer. Looks like it was kind of quiet for a while before the diagnosis went public. Like, what was, you know, going through your mind hearing that, you know, obviously a life-changing situation with your doctor, and how did that impact your philosophy with coaching?
Yeah, wow, that's another good question. And, you know, number one, it's another surreal moment. And naturally, you know, hit you like a ton of bricks in terms of the force, you know, of that message, that diagnosis, when you receive the call. And I definitely needed time to process. You know, I only shared it with my wife at the time, Mary, and my mother and father. I didn't share it with anybody else, partly because I just still need to process. And then also on a practical level, you know, after my first year, we lost, I think, 12 players moved on who had used their eligibility. Just an unusual, probably unprecedented at the higher levels in terms of power conference situations to have that degree of an imbalance of your roster. And so we knew that, you know, our eyes were open that, hey, we inherited 12 seniors, but, you know, we basically were going to be starting over in year two, almost like an expansion team, you know, Tampa Bay or something, the Devil Rays. And so I wanted to make sure that we signed a class first. And we were able to sign the number three rated class in the country, Reese Harkless and Amir Garrett, Jakar Sampson, Dom Pointer, Phil Green, D'Angelo Harrison, Norvell Pell, who was going to come, but didn't end up, you know, arriving. There were some eligibility issues at that intersection. God's Gift was a junior college player. So we reloaded rather quickly. But I wanted to get through that season. I also didn't want our first season to be a situation where anything would take away or distract from, you know, all of our energies being focused on the task at hand. And I thought that senior class deserved it. Norm Roberts had done a wonderful job of kind of stabilizing St. John's program. And, you know, the next step, you know, our responsibility being the new staff was to take the baton from Norm Roberts and move it forward and make a postseason, to make an NCAA tournament, because it had been a decade since St. John's had been in the NCAA tournament. And a wonderful group, DJ Kennedy and Paris Horn and Malik Booth and Dwight Hardy and Justin Burrell and, you know, a number of other players. Dwayne Polley was a freshman on that team, who was the, I think, California player of the year, LA player of the year. So I didn't want anything to derail, you know, our focus, our momentum. And I thought, you know, sharing the news of my cancer could potentially do that, given, you know, we had our sights on trying to make an NCAA tournament, send these seniors out in a deserving fashion. And then there was that other element that I wasn't ready to share something so personal. And I was fortunate my father had cancer and also a quadruple and a triple bypass after a massive heart attack that he suffered in his 40s. And then he had a triple bypass in his 70s. So I was fortunate to have a father who had been through a great deal and was there as a support mechanism and to kind of share his experiences with cancer. And so that was a great sounding board. And then at the end of the season, you know, we had already signed that number three class in the country. And that's when, you know, naturally I shared it with our school president, our athletic director, and then began to really roll up the sleeves and do the research on what was going to be the best, treatment, you know, for my cancer. And, Peter Scardino was my surgeon and, highly recommended. He came from, Sloan Memorial Kettering, or I may have a sequence of those, that name out of, you know, out of order, but he was an outstanding doctor and saved my life. And so I'm indebted and grateful to him forever. And I'd say big picture, you know, as you get older, life experiences, again, back to that, you know, perspective and looking at the world through a different lens, a different prism, you know, losing my my father in 2013, shortly after my own cancer battle. I lost my dad on February 10th, 2013, right before we played Syracuse in the Carrier Dome. And then losing my mother January 25th, 2018, you know, and the cancer, and being shown the door at St. John's after we made the NCAA tournament. All those things inform, you know, just a different perspective. And you are grateful, you know, to be able to get up in the morning and have a pep in your step and be able to go get a cup of coffee here in the neighborhood and to get my steps in terms of walking and, you know, to be able to now follow the trajectory of, you know, my UCLA players who are now, you know, 20, 25 years out of UCLA and thriving in their respective journeys. And then now watching my St. John's players who are in their late 20s and early 30s and to follow their careers. That's really what it's about, is the relationships and wanting to participate in the dreams and aspirations of young people, just like those coaches and mentors and parents and teachers that participated in my journey and my aspirations and dreams. And so you're bringing it full circle. And to me, that's the most rewarding and important aspect of teaching and coaching and mentoring. And so I've been fortunate, been blessed, grateful for this 33-year run associated with basketball as a broadcaster and a coach. And to be able to go back and forth makes it even more unique and special. And then meeting friends like you and being able to participate with you guys today on this podcast.
Really appreciate that.